Hi guys, are you finding problem with the program selection at the university level, or you just completed a CHS or you're about to complete and you're confused about the program you want to choose? Please, this is the right place for you because we are going to talk of those stuff. Before I start, let me tell you one thing. You must choose a program that is in alignment with the career you want to pursue. Yeah, the kind of work you want to do in the near future or the career you want to enter. Please, that is how you should choose a program. You understand? So the purpose of my video is to help you that way. We are talking of programs and we are telling you some of the careers you can pursue when you finish that program. Because if you don't choose the right program, please listen, you complete university and you'll be unemployed. You won't even get a job to do. So let's get started. Today we are starting off Bachelor of Science Management Education. This is a program that lots of universities are doing, and I will tell you some of them, so don't worry. The program is designed to equip students, you are applying, or some of us that we are in the school. The program is designed to help us with relevant knowledge, professional competencies and attitudes that will help us to teach business management subject at pre-tertiary level. When I say pre-tertiary level, I mean SHS level. So that's the first phase of the program. And then the second aim of the program is to equip us to function as administrative or training officers in the public and civil services, as well as the private sectors. What it means that the office work, the managerial work that you are dreaming of in any organization or thinking of going to do in any company, the program is also going to equip you with the knowledge at that area so that you mix anything. So this program particularly is actually helping you in two folds. It's giving you the educational area or the educational competencies so that you can be able to teach management subjects in the SHS level, and it's also helping you to put you at the office. I hope you understand. All right, so let's look at few courses in the program. We have a lot of courses. We will do like 50 plus, or at least 47 to 40 to 50. Yeah, so you are going to learn a whole lot. It's very fun, so don't get nervous and don't be afraid. But let's look about 4 or 5 courses and see how things are here. The first one I'm going to talk about is office management and practice. This is going to equip you with the knowledge at the office. You know, when you complete school, when you are undergraduate or when you are graduate from a university, first degree, we don't push you from the lower level to the top just straight. No, the best thing you can ever get, or if the company is on your for your father, the best place you can ever get to work is personal assistant or secretary or something like that. So this program is actually going to help you with all that you need to know at the office, what you're supposed to do, how a personal assistant is supposed to act, how manager is supposed to respond to you, the communication skills over there, the dressing code, you know, the letters, how to write, all those stuff. So office management is very fun and it's going to help you a lot. All right, let's go to the next course that you will do in this program that I want to talk about. That is management French. I know most of you are confused, but sorry, you gotta do French because it's very funny and it's very interesting. French is going to help you and your organization, the organization that you want to go and work with or work for, to expand it to Francophone countries. You know, Ghana is around Ghana is in between Francophone countries. So if your company or your organization wants to move outside the country, please, you are the best person because of your French to go there. And trust me, you can even be the manager because of your French. So when you are doing French as a course, it's a 2 years. When you're doing French as a course in this program, pay much attention because it's very funny and it's very interesting. All right, and you'll be employed as soon as you complete because we don't have a lot of French students in the country. So if you have one, we pamper them and we put them at the right place. All right, let's move on to a different course, and that is entrepreneurship management. I know most of you are thinking of opening up your own business. trust me, this course is going to help you to know all the procedures. It's all about creating new ideas, having innovative ideas, and as long as you have to create value around it, yeah, the ideas that you bring to improve the standard of the work at your organization or how you want things to be done, yes, you are going to create value around it. When you create the value and then you bring the profit, then you'll be respected. Yeah, your company is going to respect you when you are such a person. And if you don't work in any company and you want to do it on your own too, you are going to be respected and you have your freedom and you are good to go. We also have something like business and company law. Yeah, they are two courses, but they are similar. So that's why I'm combining them. It's all about telling you the legal requirements of your business or your company. What the company is supposed to do? The taxes, the social corporate responsibilities, what you're supposed to do, how you're supposed to operate in the country. I hope you are getting me. You can't go beyond your limit. You have laws for companies. So if you have this knowledge, you know how to, when you open a business, know how to go, how to operate, how to start, how to fund the business, how to sell stocks, how to invest, call people for investment. You know, a whole lot. So this course or this program is very nice for you. All right, we also do human resources management, we do marketing management, we do project management, we do basic accounting, and we also do international business, we do strategic planning, we do a whole lot. But let me talk of international business. International business goes beyond importing and exporting, but if you want to go into importing and exporting, yes, this program will help you because you are going to have international business as a course. And if you want your, if your career is in alignment with international business, pay much attention to it and learn it well because it's going to help you a lot. Yes, so don't let this program go if you want to go into international business, like importing and exporting. Like I said, it goes beyond that, but for the sake of time, let me end here. One last thing I want to talk about, admission requirements. If you are thinking of coming here, somebody may ask, what grade should I get? Please pass your maths, English, and science. Maths, English, science, and social. Yes, get like A1 to B3. The universities are telling us to get A1 to C6. Trust me, if you get C6-3, no university is going to admit you unless you have protocol. Even protocol, I don't trust. So get a better grade. Do everything to get a better grade. The university doesn't care about how you got it. All they care is your information presented to them is authentic. That's what WAEC gave you. So do everything. When I say strategy, yes, I know my boys understand strategies. Yeah. So do everything to get the grade. Do you get it? So your core subjects A1 to B3 is cool, or C4 is cool, but I don't aim for C6 like 3. If you have C6-1, you are cool. You are good to come. If you're also business students, you don't have problem that much because business students, this program is actually a business management education program. So when you are applying, bring management first. Let management be your first choice. So get management, accounting, and costing, or economics. If you're also not a business student, get your economics. Yeah, get like A1 to B3 because, you know, they are selecting based on those who have done well. So get it, all right? So when you get a 3 core subject, like A1 to C4, A1 to C5, it's cool. Don't aim for C6. Like if you get 3, trust me, you will suffer a bit. So when you get your economics and you pass additional 2, so that the electives will be 3, you can apply for this program. All right. Talking of the school fees will be fun and will be very relevant, but I don't know other universities, so I'm going to talk of my university, which is Akintana Apiamienkaa University of Skills Training and Entrepreneurship Development. When you are coming like 2022 or 2023, prepare like 1,700 to 2,000. Yeah, 1,700 to 2,000, 2022. Those coming that year should prepare like that. I don't know other universities, but I'll be doing a lot of programs and their respective careers. So when I get to maybe KNUST program, I also tell you their school fees over there. So stick with me and don't go anywhere. All right, friends, we are bringing this video to an end, but I'll ask you one thing. Please subscribe and then click the notification button so when I drop any video of such content, you won't miss it. And then invite your friends so that you guys will choose the right program at the university. Don't go and choose any program that you don't understand and you can't even do it and you can't even pass it. Please, the degree is very important and the knowledge you are going to get is very important and it must be based on the career you want to pursue. I hope you understand. So friends, let's keep in touch. Please subscribe and then we are good to go. Please, I am a friend. I am Augustine Esiedu, and invite your friends so that we can all be friends and we choose the right program at the right universities so that we can be employed or open up business when we complete school. Thank you.